People always ask me, how do I build what I build in Satisfactory? Here are some tips and tricks. First up, creating angles with barriers. Grab yourself a barrier, use the mouse wheel to rotate, place on an angle, grab yourself a wall, aim at the barrier, hold control. The wall then replaces the barrier to create a unique angle. Again, put a second one down, place on an angle, get a window this time, hold control, and place. Two different walls on two different angles. Number two, a couple of ways you can utilize pillars. The first cool thing you can do with pillars is grab yourself a beam connector, place it on the ground, then grab yourself a pillar. It should then go horizontal on the side of the connector. Then you can just place multiple of these, remove the connector on the end, grab yourself a conveyor attachment, place that down, grab yourself a conveyor, bring that across the top, and then you can remove the unwanted gap underneath your conveyor belt, and it looks pretty cool. So another cool thing you can do with pillars is if you go to a machine or a storage unit, you can actually place the pillar in front of it, just like so. Grab yourself a beam connector, make it level with the output or the input on the machine or the storage unit, place it down, grab yourself a framed pillar, place that down, make like a horizontal track, and then remove the pillar. Remove the connector, get yourself another small frame pillar, clip that through the storage container, so as you can see, then grab yourself a belt, and then bring that through. As you can see, that makes a cool little belt. If you wanted to, you can even grab some connectors, just to give this a bit of legs underneath, just so it doesn't look a little bit floating in midair. And there you go, a cool little way, or a feature, to use with pillars. Number three, how to make circles with walkways. So grab yourself a walkway, attach it to the side of the foundation, place the first one straight ahead, grab the second one, and then if you hold control and scroll with the mouse wheel, either up or down, as you can see it rotates, then hold control and click. And as you can see, it'll automatically change to the correct angle that the next one should be placed at. This then creating a full circle. Number four, how to create half foundations. So the first thing you want to do is make sure you're at the same level as what you want your placed item to be at. First, grab yourself a walkway and then attach it to the side of the foundation. Second, grab yourself the foundation, attach it to the walkway. This then creating a half block. As you can see, this is the corner of this block right here, and then this is now creating a half block. So what you can do is you could attach that to the end, remove this walkway, then create a wall right here, and then you could build a window, like for example there, creating a half window, and if you wanted to on the other side, you could even flip a door and create a half door. And then from here you can experiment with just placing foundations or walls in any general location, so you can make a nice little compact building. You could also remove the half foundations now if you wanted to, and bring back the old ones to match your grid, and then they'll still be attached, and you can just bring these across and play around with some cool little designs. Simple. Tip number five, creating unique windows. Okay, so the first design is pretty simple. Grab yourself a pillar, place it down, build it up by two, then go over by two spots or whatever distance you want to go to, build a beam kind of across with the pillar. Now we can place these horizontally. Then grab a window, place it down. You can even stack this on top, then do something like this with a door, and also place a window on top, creating a small window here. And when you go out to design your second floor, you can even utilize this small window here by just grabbing a half wall and just playing around with stuff like that. So on the second floor, it'll be a different aesthetic. So a second way you can play with windows, you can use ramp walls. If we get a ramp wall normal and then place the window inside of that, you can see it's creating a weird half diagonal wall. But then you can actually grab a inverted one, copy the window above, and now you have one diagonal wall, and you can create some cool aesthetics with this. If you wanted to, you could just add some doors onto the edge of this, and then you can just copy this design onto the other side to create the same design. And there you go. And then you've got an automatic door for possibly your vehicles or trains. tip number 6, how to create small wall lights. Okay, so I've quickly just set up a quick example of what it will look like from the outside. As you can see, it looks nice and clean. There's not one of them big lights, and it's just nice outside your building. So let me show you how this is done. So all you need to do is go around to where you would like the wall position, the light positioned, and then place your light down. I'm going to place mine here into this pillar, which kind of makes a little bit of sense. It should then start peeping through, just like it is there. Then you're going to want to connect the power cable. So grab your power line, connect it underneath or where you have your desired power. Connect that up, the power should come on. And if you don't have a power switch, make sure you set your lights from here, because you won't be able to access it in a minute without deleting. Place your foundation back over, then grab the column, and then just cover the light with the column, because now we can do this all with the power of the soft clipping. And then we can just hide it. And then if we go outside, we should now have two spotlights. Pretty simple, and it's pretty neat, right? Tip number 7 is how to copy and paste. Okay, so this one is pretty simple, and a lot of people probably already know how to do this. But I'm doing this because a lot of people, and I mean an insane amount of people, ask me how to do it. More than likely, it's because they're new to Satisfactory. All you veterans should know how to do this, more than likely. So all you do is you aim at a location, you press your dismantle key, which is what I prefer to use, and then it should highlight. Once you highlight it, press the middle mouse button, and then copy and paste complete. Done. You can do this with the windows, you can do this with pillars, you can do this with machines, you can do it with a lot. You can even do it with foundations. You can do every single thing with the copy and paste, and it helps so much and help you to quick build. Tip number 8, how to precisely place a buildable object. Okay, so this one can be a little bit tricky. As you can see, the foundations always have a grid for your placement. But what if you wanted to precisely put it in this square here? And how you do that is the magic of plates. What you want to do is grab your plates, place it on the ground, and then grab your light. And as you can see, it now free moves in this location. So you could just pick these up, move them to wherever you want. That's why I said it's a little bit hard to play around with, but as soon as you get the sweet spot, you can then place it. As you can see now, that is now in a position that I couldn't do before on the grid. If I go over here, as you can see, I can't snap it to that point I placed it. A good example of this is this right here. You can't place a lamppost, a power pole in the middle of this. So what you would do is you'll get your plates, place them down, and get it a little bit more central, grab your power pole, and now I'm easily able to place it. Just remove them, and then I can just easily connect a power up through there, where you normally wouldn't be able to do it. And you can do this with like many other ways as well. You can do this with like light posts, you can do this with signs, you can do this with quite a few things if you're trying to like unsnap it from the grid to place it freely because of collision. Tip number 9, another one that I get asked a lot, is how to mass delete. Okay, so the dismantle tool is pretty easy, those that have been playing Satisfactory for a while, but if you are new, you probably don't know about it. So if you press F, you will pull up the dismantling tool. If you hold control, you can do a mass deletion. But for example, let's say if you didn't want this foundation to be deleted, you can now press control, because in update 5, they have now added the abilities for you to deselect what you would like not to be deleted. And then you can just delete that and done. And there we have it, guys. That was my tips and tricks video. So thank you so much for watching. And if you do want to see more of my content, my socials are in the description below. We can come and check me out over on Twitch, where I do stream Monday through to Friday at 10 a.m. BST every single day. Come and say hello, come and give us a smile, and also come and give us a click, give us a follow, and then let me know that you did come from this video as well. I do have a Satisfactory Update 5 Let's Play series coming soon, and I will be dropping another one of these tips and tricks soon as well. So thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, leave a comment, let me know what your favorite feature was in this episode or this tips and tricks, and I'll make sure I'll respond. So keep smiling, and I'll see you in another video.